At the meeting held behind closed doors, the Iranian Vice President Mohammad Nahavandian briefed President Buhari on the ongoing political and security situation in the Middle East region. His country, he emphasized, is willing to support Nigeria in the fight against terrorism and insurgency. President Buhari welcomed the Iranian defeat of ISIS in Iraq and Syria, saying the disposition of the terrorists of their oil wells means that access to resources used to support Boko Haram in the Lake Chad region had been lost.
Iran has made huge advances and is self-sufficient in the whole value chain of the petroleum industry, and the belief is that there's a real opportunity for two big countries like that to work together in that area. Iran in particular talks about great strides that they've made in the area of irrigation in some hostile desert areas, and that this could also be of benefit to Nigeria, where we've had the shrinking of Lake Chad.
On the planned joint commission, the two leaders promised to work very hard towards its realization, saying Nigeria and Iran can do a lot more together in the best interests of their economies and people.
The firm belief there was that there was a lot of complementarity between the two countries and our economies, and that we really should take this opportunity to come together, work together, and achieve a real win-win.
President Muhammadu Buhari also engaged President Obiang Nguema Basogo of Equatorial Guinea, where they promised to do all that is necessary to absolutely secure the Gulf of Guinea. President Buhari said Nigeria is as worried as everyone is about piracy, kidnapping, smuggling, and other vices being perpetrated in the maritime domain.
Mr. President pointed out that, of course, we share maritime borders, and it's a real menace for the two countries. So we're looking at a security architecture that's going to come into place to really address this this scourge.
In another meeting with OPEC Secretary General Mohamed Sanusi Barkindo, President Muhammadu Buhari was briefed on the upcoming meeting in December at which output production quotas will be shared. The current agreement is expected to elapse in March next year.
For us in Nigeria, every barrel is important. We need to retain and in fact get more in view of the circumstances of our own country. So as it is, Nigeria is feeling dissatisfied with the cuts ordered on us. And I think that our president is preparing to really fight all of that, to see that the exemption we have enjoyed for a long time is reinstated.
President Buhari gave assurances of his personal involvement in securing the best possible deal for Nigeria. In the meantime, the Nigerian leader has arrived Daura, Katsina State, on a five-day visit. Governor Aminu Bello Masari of Katsina State led a high-powered delegation to accord him a befitting welcome at Umaru Musa Yar'Adua International Airport. The president, who departed the airport by chopper, was received at Daura helipad on arrival by his kith and kin, led by the emir of Daura, Umar Farouk Umar. President Buhari is expected to perform some official engagements before returning to Abuja on Tuesday. In Daura, Katsina State, Adamu Sambu, NTA News.